My name is Scott Ratliff. I'm with the Boston Cannons and Maverick Lacrosse, as well as with LB3 Lacrosse down in Atlanta. Today I'm going to talk a little bit about my stick positioning, how I like to pick up ground balls in traffic and in space. So when approaching a ground ball, I kind of like to think of it in two different ways, right? If I'm approaching a ground ball and I'm in an open space, so I've got room on either side of me, not expecting to get checked right as I pick up the ball, I'm going to make sure I'm holding my hands about hip width at the bottom of my stick. I'm going to approach the ball. When I scoop through it to pick it up, rather than trying to keep it tight to my body or to bring it up immediately, I like to scoop through it, get it out in front of me, keep it in space, right? I like to keep it out to the side here so I can feel my defense, use my body to protect it. And then as I carry, as I get into more space, I'll start to bring the stick up. When I bring the stick up off the ground, I like to still maintain my hands at the bottom of the stick to keep the stick as far away as possible from my defenders and keep my body in between myself and them. Once I get it up and I'm bringing it up to make a pass, then you'll see me move my hands up the stick. I find that I have a little bit more control holding my hands, again, about hip width apart, but more towards the middle of the stick. This way you can protect the top end and you can also protect the bottom end with cradling and with moving the stick. When I approach a ground ball and I'm in traffic, so in this sort of situation, I'm expecting that right as I get here, I'm gonna be receiving a check on my stick. In this type of situation, I like to move my top hand up the stick. Doing so allows me to pick up a ground ball a little more vertically with my stick, which can be helpful in traffic so you're not getting checked on your back hand. What it also does is it makes your hold on the stick a little bit stronger. If my top hand's up higher and I go through this ground ball, I'm gonna be able to take a check, hold it with my wrist, and run through it. If I go through that ground ball with both of my hands down on the bottom of the stick, that check is gonna jar the ball loose. So once I get this ball in traffic, pick it up with my top hand high, cradling it down low, and I'll keep it down here until I can get out to space. Once I get out to space, again, I'll move my hands back down to the middle of the stick, about hip width apart, and I'll get it up right by my ear so I can make a pass. So to wrap it up, the last thing here is when we're approaching a ball, when we find that ball and we've located it on the ground, it's important to take a look to your right and to your left and to understand your surroundings. Depending on where our defenders are, that's gonna depend on how we approach that ground ball and how we play out of it. So make sure we identify our surroundings and then play the ball the right way. Thanks for watching.